What's up, geeks, and welcome to the channel. Given a collection of intervals, represented as pairs of start and end times, the goal is to merge overlapping intervals and return an array of the non-overlapping intervals that cover all the intervals in the input. To note that an interval AB overlaps with another interval CD if and only if C is smaller or equal to B and A is smaller or equal to D. So our task is to merge such intervals into a condensed set, ensuring that no two intervals in the result overlap. A natural starting point is the brute force method, where we compare each interval with every other interval to check for overlaps. A straightforward implementation of this method involves nested loops, where the outer loop iterates through each interval and the inner loop checks for overlaps. If overlaps are found, the intervals are merged. This approach ensures correctness but is suboptimal in terms of complexity. The brute force approach has a time complexity of O of n squared, since in the worst case, each interval needs to be compared with every other interval. This is highly inefficient, especially as the number of intervals grows. Okay, given the impracticality of the brute force solution for large inputs, during an interview, we will be asked to come up with a more efficient algorithm. You see, when it comes to intervals, and in 90% of the problems involving intervals, always keep in mind sorting. Sorting the intervals by either their lower or upper bound. Sorting by lower bound, which in this case represents the start times, is a common strategy in interval-related problems. This ensures that intervals with earlier start times come first in the sorted array. Take the same array of intervals we had as an example. Let's start by sorting the intervals based on their start times in ascending order. While iterating through the intervals, all we need to check is if the end time of the last interval we verified is smaller than the start time of the next interval in line. If the start time of an interval is smaller than the end time of the last one, it means there is an overlap and these intervals need to be merged. To implement this, and as we just mentioned, we begin by sorting the intervals based on their start times. This step is crucial for optimizing the identification of overlaps. Once the intervals are sorted, we iterate through the sorted list. If no overlap is found, then the interval is simply added to the list. However, if the intervals overlap, then we simply update the upper bound of the verified interval to take into consideration the interval we want to merge it with. The dominant factor in terms of complexity is the sorting operation, resulting in a total time complexity of O of n log n. This is a significant improvement over the brute force approach. But how do we know when to sort by start times? Why haven't we sorted the intervals by end times in this example? You see, if you've watched the previous video of this series, links in the card above, you may have already guessed that this type of intervals problem falls under the partitioning category. What do I mean by that? You see, there are mainly two types of intervals problems, the ones that fit into interval partitioning and the ones that fit into interval scheduling. Every interval problem can be thought of as process having a certain running time, which is their interval, and that interval needs to be scheduled or partitioned and distributed to use available resources. In interval partitioning, we need to keep track of which processes are currently running so we know which resources are free and we're able to allocate them effectively. So, we need to know when each process starts to be able to account for that. Hence, sorting by start time would be more natural and intuitive in this case. On the other hand, for interval scheduling, we don't necessarily need to monitor which processes are currently running. When a process finishes, we can easily check whether the resource is available or not, and if it is, then we can allocate it to a new process. In this case, sorting by end times seems to be more natural and intuitive. Let us know in the comments below if you'd like us to solve more interval problems. And that's it for this video. I hope it was helpful. Thank you guys for watching. Take care, and I will see you in the next one.